Hello gardening friends. Today we're going to talk about an invasive species that might be in your yard. This is lesser celandine. The Latin is Ficaria verna. It was also called ranunculus ficaria. It's native to Europe, Asia, Northern Africa, and it was likely introduced to the United States as an ornamental garden plant. There are actually some named varieties out there. Now this is low growing. It forms a mat. As you can see, the leaves are kind of kidney shaped, is what they call it. And it has this lovely little buttercup-like flower. Now the flowers are triggered by water availability in the spring, so start looking for them early in April. Lesser celandine can be a problem because it emerges a lot earlier than our native plants. And because it has such a dense root system and underground bulbs, our native smaller plants like trilliums, bloodroot, and spring beauty just can't get established or are overrun by this plant. Now, when this dies back, probably in end of May or by June, because it is an ephemeral, you'll basically have bare soil and you might have other weeds come in and take over at that point. Now I wanted to show you the structure of this because if you're trying to manage it, you have to make sure that you get all of these little bulbs gone. Now it also sets seed, but if you're doing hand digging on small areas, this is what you have to make sure you dig out. So it's a challenge to effectively control it. As you see, it will spread over time. So plants that are removed, you should bag them up and put them in the garbage. Small infestations, like I said, you can dig out by hand. But for larger infestations, you may have to use an herbicide. Now, herbicide use, it's really most effective before the plants start to flower. And in Western New York, that can be difficult because temperatures need to be above 50 degrees and you have to have 12 hours without rain. When possible, you also want to make applications before any non-target plants have emerged. And I would contact your local extension office or invasive species organization for specifics on herbicide use. And whenever you spray an herbicide, always read the label, follow the directions for rates, spraying conditions, as well as personal protective equipment. Okay, so check your yards for lesser celandine and don't let this invasive take over your property. Have a great day.